Now, many of us make New Year's resolutions and goals at this time of the year. Maybe you're one of those people that picks a word for the year. Maybe you're setting up a new routine. But what about goals as a family? What about getting your entire family involved and planning out an entire year? Today, I'm going to show you guys a fun way to plan out your entire year to have the best year ever. Hey guys, it's Vani from Mrs. Mom's Homeschool. And if you're new to my channel, I am a homeschooling mom of three children and I make videos on everything to help you on your homeschooling journey. But I also make motherhood videos so that even if you're not a homeschooler, you will still get some things out of this channel. And if you're interested on some fun ways to celebrate New Year's Eve this year with your family, make sure you check out the video here. You won't want to miss those ideas and the follow-up video after that, which shows it in action. And while you're at it, why don't you go ahead and subscribe and ring the notification bell, because I have a lot of fun, motivating videos coming up to get you on a path to live the best life that you can as a mom this year. So today I want to share with you a very cool idea I got from someone else somewhere else. And that is planning your entire year. So I'm not just talking about goals. I want to lose weight. I want to make this much money by the end of the year. I want to read 12 books. I'm talking about planning out your entire year with tentative things and activities that you want to do this year. Now, obviously, I say tentative because life happens, but they are more likely to happen if you make a plan. A Harvard Business study found that there's a direct correlation between those who set goals and their success. In fact, it was found that 14%, the 14% of people who do make goals, that's not even a lot of people who make goals, but the 14% of people who do make goals are 10 times more successful than those who do not. So there's a reason for you guys to make some goals this year. With that being said, if you have a vision for your future and you have a vision for your life and you have it down on paper, you are going to work towards it to make sure that it happens, right? It just makes sense. So all you need to do this is an annual planner, a pencil, and your family. And maybe your cell phone, which has dates and things like that inside of it. So the main idea behind planning your year is that you're going month by month and you are putting down events and things that are important to you along with things that you want to do. So the first thing you want to go ahead and write down into your calendar is the birthdays of everybody that is important to you. If you go on Facebook, I believe you can somehow find a list of the birthdays of some of your friends that you may not know by memory. If you don't know your very close friend's birthday, start gathering those dates and putting them in your phone, and then you can put them into your calendar. Of course, you have your immediate family and your extended family's birth dates. Anybody that you want to send a card to, send a gift to, take them out for the birthday or throw a party for, all these people should be, or even like send a phone call, make a phone call or a Marco Polo, all these things should be down in your planner so that when that day comes, you're not going to forget to say happy birthday to that person or to celebrate with them. The second thing you want to plan is the holidays. So there are a ton of holidays. Obviously, we have the main holidays like Christmas and Thanksgiving and New Year's, which definitely you want to, if you want to take a trip in December or if you want to do something special for New Year's next year, that's definitely something you want to put down on your calendar with a set plan, because you want to look ahead and see how much money needs to be saved, who am I inviting, give them advance notice so that this trip that you're planning on taking or this special event that you're going to make happen actually does happen. But you can also think of other little holidays like Leprechaun, St. Patrick's Day. We call it Leprechaun Day because every St. Patrick's Day, my kids like to make leprechaun traps. So, and there's other little holidays. Maybe you want to celebrate like National Pancake Day or, you know, make some fun. If you have little kids, it's always fun to celebrate those little insignificant but silly holidays that will make your kids remember those events. Field trips for your kids. If you're a homeschooling parent, you want to set up some field trips in advance. Right now, we shoot for a lot of outdoor activities and things that you know that are going to stay open. But still, shooting for some things that you guys want to do with throughout the year. And if you are a mom of a child who goes to school, I don't know if they're still doing field trips right now, but you definitely still, once you get those dates, put those into your calendar so you're not forgetting to, you know, buy lunches or pay for the thing or whatever it is that you guys have to do. Another thing are family activities that you want to try. Maybe some weekend activities. Maybe you guys want to do an escape room one day or go ziplining or do a ropes course. put scatter those throughout your year. Put maybe one cool activity a month to do with your family. That way every month you're looking ahead for the month to see what things you need to save for, what babysitters you need, anything like that. And every Sunday you can go back and take a look for the week and see more in detail, zoom in on those on that week and see what needs to get done to achieve those goals. You want to think about date nights with your spouse, date nights, date days with your children, girls' days with your girl best friend. That you, everybody, we all need some time with the girls. You want to think about time with your family. Who do you want to invite over for dinner this year? Do you have relatives that you never invited over? Do you have new friends that you met? You want to invite them over for dinner? Put that on your calendar too. For those you may want to ask what would be a good time, or just go ahead and throw it down for, you know, April. And then when April comes, you can go ahead and ask them, you know, I want to have you guys over for dinner. When are you guys available this month? Play dates for your children. You guys can plan that weekly because things change a lot when you're a homeschooler and you have a play date. Sometimes something happens and that play date gets canceled. So having a play date a month in advance is probably not that good of an idea unless you're doing like a group play date. Like maybe you have a bunch of kids you want to take to the zoo or to do paintball or to do laser tag or something fun like that. Then you definitely want to plan that one ahead of time. Vacations and places you want to go. What do you want to do for your spring break and your winter break? Make sure you put those things on the calendar as well. And any outings and events with others that you may want to do. I was creating a photo album. I make my photo albums on Snapfish. I did like digital scrapbooks, and I was doing 2 years behind. I'm finishing up the 2018 one, and I saw that we got a bunch of my cousins and a bunch of close friends and all of our kids, and we went and we stayed at a nearby beach resort, and we stayed there over just one night. We stayed there, and I have so many pictures of us in the pool and in the hotel rooms, and it was so much fun, and we never did it again. So I want to do that again this year, so I'm going to put that on my calendar. What are some things that you think would be awesome that you may want to try with others or with your family or by yourself? Put all of those things on the calendar and let's make it happen. I wish you guys a very, very, very happy and successful new year. I'm going to be sharing a lot of different tips to help you guys make this your best new year yet, because I am on a path to just somewhere great, and I'm just have so many ideas and so many goals, so many things that I want to do, and I want to share those things with you guys. So make sure you take a moment to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you won't miss another video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.